The investigation that felled the head of the CIA has expanded to include a high-ranking U.S. military figure. That news rippled outward from the Pentagon today and across official Washington.
Good to see you. Good to be here.
The name of U.S. Marine General John Allen, the top American commander in Afghanistan, surfaced overnight in the scandal that began Friday with David Petraeus resigning as CIA director. Unnamed defense officials said the military is now investigating possibly, quote, inappropriate communications between Allen and Tampa socialite Jill Kelly. She'd reported getting harassing emails from another woman, Paula Broadwell. The FBI investigation that followed uncovered Broadwell's affair with Petraeus. But according to the newest revelations, agents also found extensive contacts between Kelly and General Allen. The FBI notified the Pentagon on Sunday, and last night, spokesman George Little read a statement from Defense Secretary Leon Panetta on a flight to Australia.
Today, the Secretary directed that the matter be referred to the Inspector General of the Department of Defense for investigation, and it is now in the hands of the Department's Inspector General.
Early news accounts said Allen and Kelly exchanged 20 to 30,000 pages of emails and other documents over the last 2 years. For part of that time, the general served as deputy commander at U.S. Central Command, based at MacDill Air Force Base in Tampa, where Jill Kelly and her husband often organized social events for the military. One senior defense official said today that the emails between Allen and Kelly were mostly routine and involved planning for parties. Another described them as, quote, flirtatious. For his part, Allen denied any wrongdoing. The four-star general took over command in Afghanistan in July of 2011 from then-General David Petraeus.
It is my intention to maintain the momentum of this campaign, this great campaign on which we have embarked.
In that role, Allen is also overseeing the pullout of U.S. combat forces and transition to an Afghan takeover of security by 2014.
What the people of Afghanistan want is to be protected by Afghans. What the international community wants is for the Afghan people to be protected by Afghans. That's an important outcome, and that's what victory looks like in the fight against the Taliban.
Last month, Allen was nominated for Supreme Commander of NATO, a role he was expected to assume in the spring. Now his confirmation process has been put on hold, and Pentagon officials say they hope to speed up confirmation of General Joseph Dunford as Allen's successor in Afghanistan. At the White House today, Press Secretary Jay Carney said President Obama still has faith in General Allen and is not contemplating shakeups in his national security team.
He's focused on the missions that the military is tasked with carrying out, and the CIA and the general intelligence community is tasked with carrying out, and with enacting his overall agenda.
Meanwhile, the Petraeus probe continued. FBI agents searched the home of Paula Broadwell in Charlotte, North Carolina, late last night. And at the U.S. Capitol today, returning lawmakers were still looking for answers. One was Republican Senator Susan Collins of Maine.
I am puzzled by much of what has occurred in the FBI investigation, and also the latest information that perhaps General Petraeus's friend had access to some classified information. We don't know whether that is true or not.
Others, including House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi, focused on why the FBI did not officially inform Congress about the Petraeus matter much earlier.
I think there's some answers that we have to have about notification to Congress. I don't have any reason to think that there are any national security issues at stake in what has transpired. I think some dishonorable things were done, and the honorable thing has to be to resign or not to go forward.
And the vice. In the meantime, Democratic Senator Dianne Feinstein, chair of the Intelligence Committee, said she now expects Petraeus will testify about the attack on the U.S. consulate in Benghazi, Libya, even though he's no longer head of the CIA. In a final strange twist, there was also news today about the FBI agent who was first contacted by Jill Kelly last May. The Wall Street Journal reported that he had once sent her shirtless photos of himself.